It's Sunday. Hi, welcome to another episode of Tranny Star on Sunday, and have a very good episode this week. First of all, if I need to do this, folks, I'm going to need everyone out there watching this right now to please leave the room, please. Everyone but Diana, of Tranny Star. Diana, you stay. Okay. Okay, I think everybody left. Diana? You dared me on our channel page to sing Dolly Parton, and I missed a week, so I'm going to do it now. Just a few bars, though, but you dared me, so I'm going to do it. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, blah, 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 I don't know the lyrics of this song, there you go. Diana's probably, you're probably never going to speak to me again because my singing's that horrible. Okay, folks, y'all can come in the room. Hi. Welcome back. Y'all missed nothing, trust me. Anywho, the first topic for this week is posed forth by Lacey and Megan from the YouTube channel Megan's Life. I'm going to put their link right there because you guys should all check them out. Absolutely wonderful ladies. They're very beautiful, they're very smart, they're very funny, and they have like the best videos ever. I absolutely love them. I know Megan's actually a friend of mine from online, and I have to tell you, I love her. She's one of my best friends on, she's one of my best friends. I love you, Megan. I really do. Lacey, I never met you, but I'm a fan. I think you're just awesome. You really are. And I'm so glad that, you know, you're on the Megan's channel too. You rock. I hear nothing but good things, and everything I see about you is just awesome. And I'm rambling on again. I'm sorry, folks. Okay. Question that they post on their channel is, if you transitioned, if you was to find a crystal ball and you could peer into the future and you found out that no matter how many surgeries, how long you're on HRT, you're never going to pass, would you still transition? And I think this is a very important question to pose, and everybody should definitely ask that. And I don't say this because I think, you know, because I want to discourage people from transitioning or anything like that, because definitely transitioning saved my life. It has brought me more joy than pain, and it was worthwhile. And I know that every one of y'all have thought, you know, that if transition, we're about to transition, y'all thought this out really hard. I've never known anybody that has started watching Mighty Morphin Power Ranger reruns and just said, I'm really bored. I think, you know, even though I enjoy being male, I'm going to change my gender and live my life as a woman. You know, definitely not. Nobody ever does that unless you're trans and you're truly a woman. You know, I doubt there's any women out there that transition over to being male, you know, out of boredom either, you know. I mean, but anywho, yeah, everybody should ask that question. The reason why is this. You have to give yourself realistic expectations. A lot of us are never going to pass. It's sad, but it's true. I'm never going to pass, ever in a million years. Every time I walk out that door, I know I don't pass. There's not a single person out there that, unless they're completely blind, drunk, or it's dark and foggy outside, and the person probably has glaucoma, do they not know I'm trans? I'm lucky, though, because I live in Berkeley. I'm right, like a hop, skip, and a jump away from San Francisco. So trans people are common here. More people are used to us. We're not that big of a deal. So we don't tend to, I don't tend to get stares or snickers or rude comments. However, though, even here, sometimes I do. It happens. Like Wednesday, I was walking down the street feeling good about myself, and I did walk past some young college guys, and one of the guys that saw me and like to his friend and said, "What the fuck is that? Of talking about me?" And yeah, it did hurt me, but you know, only for 10 minutes, and I just kept going on my day, and I had a great day, so yeah, I didn't let it ruin me. But you know, folks, I kind of prepared myself for that starting out in transition. I never gave myself the expectation that I was ever going to fully pass, and I'm lucky that I did, because definitely, I mean, look at this. See the brow ridge right there? That's where I have bangs. My face is always going to give it away. Granted, the hormones have given me a very, well, can't really tell from the shirt, but a very feminine shape. I mean, you know, look at that. I've got an ass. You know, it definitely, you know, I got girl arms, and but my, you know, so the hormones have definitely helped me there, but my face is always going to give me away. Because I'm never going to be able to afford feminine facial surgery. It's just the fact of life. Unless I get rich, or I win the lotto, or surgeries become free, or I get married to a very rich man, or a wealthy philanthropist decides they want to help me out and pay for my surgeries, I'm never going to have that happen. It happens, but you know, I'm not bummed about it, and you know, I don't mind, whatever, because really, I didn't transition for people. I didn't transition with the expectations that everybody was going to accept me and that, or anything. I didn't really transition for anybody else's approval but my own. So I could be happy in my skin. Not for everybody else's, because really if I wanted people to accept me and approve of me, I wouldn't have transitioned. Because I was in South Carolina and, you know, wasn't really expecting a welcoming or anything. Me transitioning, but yeah, basically though, folks, you know, I'm glad that I give myself these realistic expectations and I posed that question early on, because getting that out of the way, getting the worries, that worry out of the way, I'm able to live a very happy life. And by the way, I know beautiful women and very handsome, manly men who pass. They completely pass. Nobody's going to clock them. Even a trans person, let me tell you, like, if you're trans, you can clock a trans person a lot of times a mile away. I can. Well, trans women, sorry guys, well, y'all guys probably love it, but I can never clock any of y'all. I never can. I've walked with friends that are trans men, you know, down the street, and like, they'll be like, it's a trans guy. And I'll be like, where? Who? Over there? And they'll be like, no. That's Kenny Loggins, it's not a trans guy, you know. Usually then my reaction is, oh my god, it's the Antichrist of music, let's run now. And by the way, if you're a big Kenny Loggins fan, I'm so sorry that you had such abuse in your life that it's obviously scarred you enough for you to think that Kenny Loggins is a very good musician. He's not. His music has hurt many, many people. Oh, and while we're on the truths of life, the hokey pokey is a lie. But anywho, yeah, I do know people that pass, that they completely pass. They blend into society, and even them, they weren't worried, am I being stared at because somebody likes the way I look, or because they can tell I'm trans. And these people, I'm telling you, they're very beautiful people and everything. So really, it's not like surgeries and hormones is going to always take away that insecurity. Unfortunately, a lot of that insecurity does stay with us for the rest of our lives. It's an albatross on a trans person's back. You just kind of learn to deal with it. And folks, it does help to kind of go through society with kind of this, if somebody has a problem with me, fuck them. They're the one with the problem. Why should I give a shit? Not to be vulgar. But anywho, another topic for this week, and this was posed by GusherJizmac666 on my personal channel. He emailed me this. By the way, sir, I'm assuming you're a sir. If you're not, I apologize, but I catch the Guar reference. Right on. Yeah. But yeah, he asked me, who or what influenced me to start to get on YouTube? And basically, it's not really Basically, I wish I could tell you that it was because I had a burning desire to share my experience with my fellow trans sisters and brothers, and that way, and to teach what I've learned. But it wasn't, no. Basically, what happened was I was a moderator, and I still am a moderator. I haven't been there for a while, but I do plan on coming back if you are from this chat room. But I was a moderator at Susans.com on their chat room, and what happened was one night all my friends were showing pictures of themselves on their Flickr accounts. I had no pictures because, believe it or not, I know I almost make a vid like every day. I know that I sometimes, I don't make a lot of vids, but folks, I hate pictures. Absolutely hate it. Yes, I can't stand it. And I have no photos of myself, so I didn't have anything to show anybody. But, you know, I didn't want to be left out. But I had this VidCam that a friend of mine had sold to me very, very cheap. He had worked for it. It's unimportant how I got the camera. But so I decided to put it to use, and I put a vid up so my friends could see what I looked like. And that, I don't know why I would, because I looked worse than I do now, and I sounded like this. Oh, it's awful. But yeah, it was just mainly so my friends could see or hear what I sounded like. Everything else has kind of evolved into what it is now, and I'm very happy. YouTube has been very good to me. I met a lot of great friends, and I gotta tell y'all, I absolutely love y'all, and I've said this before, and I'll say it a million times because I mean it. It has been an unexpected honor that I was asked to be on Tranny Star. I can't believe that they even asked me to be on Tranny Star because, you know, they have a strict policy of only putting awesome people on Tranny Star, and I'm obviously not awesome. Okay, I'm lying. I know why they got me on. I lied on the application. I'm sorry. Tell nobody. But yeah, pretty much it was just to show my friends what I look like. That's why I got on YouTube. But yeah, that's all for this week. Oh, folks, I'm going to put his link over here. But folks, Tranny Star's very own Dylan has made a video after a month and a half. He's doing very well. I'm going to put his link to his new vid right here. And please, everybody click on it. Every single one of y'all click on it. Give him 5 stars, even if you normally don't rate. And tell him on the comment that you miss him and you're so happy he's doing well. And tell him how much he means to you. Because I'm sure, like we all do here at Tranny Star, you all love Dylan. Because, I mean, I think I speak for us all, Dylan, if you are watching. We all love you very much. You mean so much to us, and we're so happy that it looks like your life is really coming together. So happy. And congratulations on starting Tea. Your voice sounds is already on a good start. That's all for this week. Bye. I love you all. And transmission out.